Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts. I am the Overthinker, and in the last episode, we made it to Traverse Town, and I did a little bit of grinding off-screen. As you guys can see, I actually got me a new ability called Guard. All you gotta do is press square whenever you're, well, standing, and you'll do a simple block. So, with that said, in this episode, we're going to go ahead and continue on through the game. Those creatures from the island. So yes, they are. So it looks like the creatures from the island happen to actually follow us all the way over here. So let's go ahead and take care of this first batch. Don't worry, I'm not going to keep doing this. What I'll probably end up doing though is anytime we see a new enemy, I'll just fight the first couple of them. That way you guys can see what kind of attacks they do, how to get like tech points, whatnot. That way it's not just me fully battling. But we've already seen these guys, and this is just, like, the first part, so don't worry. So, they're done. As you guys can see, there were some yellow and blue balls that I'm picking up. Those are money, actually. And what is money mainly used for? Well, money. So, the item shop that we went to earlier, and Cid's accessory shop, we can actually get items such as potions, ethers, defense items, stuff like that. But anyways, doesn't look like he's here. Keep looking! So, and here, as you mean, there's not going to be any enemies that come through here. And as you can also see, these are currently closed off. Currently closed off areas we will be able to come back to in a later video, or later on throughout the game. But for now, they're closed off just for game purposes, I suppose. Anyways, let's go ahead and loop back around, and okay, these guys are really starting to bug me, because it's like I want to go somewhere, and they're like, hey, what's up? I'm going to follow you. Okay, that should be the last time I fight them, for real. Oh, wait, there's one other area that I do need to take them on. We do need to go ahead and take them on over to the left, because, as you can see, there's a treasure chest that we can get. So, let's go ahead and take out these guys. These guys aren't necessarily bad if you're a little over-leveled like I am. Yeah, I kind of did that. Anyways, what you want to do is apparently pick up this barrel. Okay, I guess I'll go ahead and place it right here, because we'll need to be up there here in just a bit. But what you want to do is open the treasure, and you get yourself a potion. So, if you're running low on potions, or you didn't fight Riku and the three guys from Destiny Island a lot, or you didn't get a lot of potions from those enemies, then yeah. Anyways, Pretty Stone. So, Pretty Stones are actually about to come in handy here pretty soon. Basically, with anytime you find yourself a Pretty Stone, they're going to be worth 30 money at the store whenever you sell them. So, if you did a lot of races, or you happen to find a lot, sell them, because they're worth a lot of money. And over here, you get your third potion. Okay, get out of my way. Fine. Okay, there. That was actually a perfect time to show guard. As you guys saw, it just press square at the right time, and you will actually be able to block your enemy's attack. Now, I will go ahead and say one thing. I'll hold off on that, because oh, wait, right here, actually. I didn't say anything about doing 100% because I wanted to get right here first. Now let's go ahead and go through this third door to the living room. And right here, 99 puppies have been lost and spread out throughout the chaos of the worlds. So I will actually be doing a 100% run. At least as far as the game really concerns, a 100% run. I am going to find all 99 Dalmatians, and there are two other requirements in order to get the secret ending on normal, which is the exact reason why I actually chose this. We chose that difficulty at the very beginning. But enough about that. So let's go ahead and take care of them. Now there is two other spots that we do actually need to go. The first one being up here. As you can see, there's a treasure chest. We can't necessarily get to it just yet, but we will maybe here in a bit. Where is he? Leon! And the gizmo shop. This area is both can either be fun or your worst nightmare come alive. So, excuse me. Basically, with this room, basically, in this area, these enemies are actually going to spawn one extra time over and over and over again until there are 9 on the screen. If you're kind of low on experience and you kind of want to grind, this is a prime spot for you to actually grind, because you get 45 experience altogether. Ooh, hey, I actually leveled up right there. Perfect timing. But anyways, I will go ahead and fight these guys, not to necessarily level up, but because I need some money. Because there are some things that I do need to buy later on, and I want to go ahead and have the money. So, with that said, I will be right back. Alrighty, I am back, and as you guys can see, I'm now level 11, and as opposed to my normal level 10 that I was when you guys saw me level up. And I got me a good bit of potions, lucid shards, which those enemies actually drop. And I now have a little under 400 money. So I believe I'm pretty good for the very beginning of the game. And I actually went the wrong way. Great. Yeah, if you guys can't tell, I kind of have a very, very bad sense of direction. Like, even in real life, it's bad. You can give me a GPS and I'll be, yeah. Anyways, you can either jump down there or, wait, what? It kind of wobbly, I guess I can't climb. Sora! Shame on you! That ladder is not wobbly. Well, okay, yeah, it is wobbly, but... No! You've climbed up trees. You've climbed up a wooden ladder that could have broken on you. No! Shame on you. Fine, whatever. So, we'll just have to come back for that other treasure chest. So what you want to do is now actually come over here to the third district. In the third district, there isn't much really going on besides me getting another lucid shard, which I don't necessarily need. And let's... Okay, get out of the way. Come on. Just go away. Just... And one more. Okay, there we go. I know I said I wouldn't go for that any more enemies if I didn't need to, but I'm sorry. So like I said, there's not really much going on over here. As you can see, currently closed off. Okay, I can't examine it until these guys are gone. So one final battle before I say yeah. Let's get... There you go. So, as you saw, it's currently closed off. And it looks like it's locked. No kidding. You don't say, Sora. It's not like you wield a giant key or something, you know. Something that could potentially probably fit in that lock, you know. But no, that wouldn't make any sense at all. No, would it? Whatever. Anyways, what you do want to go ahead and do, now that we have gone everywhere that we can in Traverse Town, that we can go to, at least for right now, you want to go ahead and head back up to the first district. So, yeah, there was a treasure chest up there, but we'll come back for that whenever we actually have a little bit more time. So, I need to stop saying so. I've been bad about that, and I know I have. Okay. Get out of my way. Enough. Get. Move. Okay, you know what? I think I should just go ahead and run. There's no point in me really fighting these guys anymore. Come on. And. Okay, that's good. Good enough for me. And I know you guys are probably getting a little aggravated with that, so let's go ahead and go in here. Now keep in mind, if you talk to Sid, a cutscene will actually activate once you step outside the store. If you go outside and after talking to Sid, you will be actually thrown not only into a cutscene, but into a slight boss, but into a mid-boss battle, actually. So if you feel like you're under level, go ahead and buy yourself a fire ring. A fire ring will come in handy very much so here in a bit. So I don't think I necessarily need it since I'm kind of a little overpowered and I have the protect chain, but whatever. So let's go ahead and save real quick and there we go. Now, like I said, once you step through these doors, a cutscene will be ready. Be ready for a scripted boss battle.
They'll come at you out of nowhere.
Who are you?
And they'll keep on coming at you, as long as you continue to wield the Keyblade. But why? Why would it choose a kid like you?
Hey, what's that supposed to mean?
Never mind. Now, let's see that Keyblade.
What? There's no way you're getting this!
All right. Then have it your way.
I will have it my way indeed, since this is Burger King, apparently, in Traverse Town. Yeah, anyways, this is Leon. He is not a required win. If you do want the experience, though, you do need to defeat him. He gives you 30 experience, so 30 experience at the very beginning of the game is very, very nice. So he only has two main types of attacks, really. He'll just jump around and try and get close combat with you and do like a two-hit combo, as you guys can see. Yikes, I kind of actually took too much damage already. Okay, I need to work on my guarding, apparently. Either way, potion time! Much better. Anyways, and his second ability, which he's doing right now, fire! Yeah, if you have the guard ability, it is going to come in handy here. That's one main reason why I actually chose the shield. I knew about this. Anyways, couple more hits and he should be good. There you go.
No way. I can lose.
Now you're gonna... Again.
Oh, you're slipping, Leon.
I went easy on him. Looks like things are worse than we thought. A lot worse.
Gorsh, there's nobody here. Sure is spooky.
Actually, I'm not scared.
Excuse me, did the king send you?
Come on, lazy bum. Wake up. You okay?
I guess.
Those creatures that attacked you are after the Keyblade. But it's your heart they really want, because you wield the Keyblade.
I'm so glad that you're okay, Kairi.
Kairi? Who are you talking about? I'm the great Ninja Yuffie.
Hmm?
I think you might have overdone it, Squall.
That's Leon.
The Keyblade.
Yeah, we had to get it away from you to shake off those creatures. It turns out, that's how they were tracking you.
It was the only way to conceal your heart from them. But it won't work for long. Still, hard to believe that you, of all people, are the chosen one.
Oh.
Well, I suppose beggars can't be choosers.
Why don't you start making sense? What's going on here?
Okay. You know there are many other worlds out there, besides your castle in this town, right?
Yeah.
But they're supposed to be a secret.
They've been secret, because they've never been connected. Until now. When the Heartless came, everything changed.
The Heartless?
The ones who attacked you, you remember?
Those without hearts.
The darkness in people's hearts, that's what attracts them.
And there is darkness within every heart.
Hey, have you heard of someone named Ansem?
Ansem?
He was studying the Heartless. He recorded all of his findings in a very detailed report.
Gorsh, can we see it?
Its pages are scattered everywhere.
Scattered?
Too many worlds.
Oh, then maybe the king went to find them.
Yes, those were my thoughts exactly.
We've got to find him, quick!
Red! Plus we need that key!
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
Exactly.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade. That's why they'll keep coming after you, no matter what.
Well, I didn't ask for this.
The Keyblade chooses its master, and it chose you.
So, tough luck.
How did all this happen? I remember being in my room. Wait a minute! What happened to my home? My island? Riku! Kairi!
You know what? I really don't know.